key driving factor is that we expect revenues to be muted than whatever has been historically observed. So prior to 2012, the sector was used to double-digit growth. In 2012, we have seen single-digit growth, and for some luxury retailers, even negative growth. We expect growth to sort of come down to 5 to 8% positive growth rate, whereas EBITDA, which has already fallen by around 7,500 basis point last year, we expect EBITDA to fall further, but at a rate lower than whatever has been observed. So we expect a further 50 to 75 basis point reduction in EBITDA. What it essentially means is that these companies, most of the large retailers, already had a negative cash flow from operations. Now, with further squeezing of EBITDA, the negative cash flow is likely to increase. To that extent, their working capital needs would be further stretched. Their liquidity may be stretched. They would require more debt funding, or at any rate, more capital infusion. So given this, we have placed the sector on negative outlook, as we expect the ratings to be under pressure. Having said that, in certain cases, we have already taken a rating action and have downgraded companies. And in a lot of the retailers that we rate are actually in sub-investment grade. So that sort of already captures the risk inherent in this industry by the low rating level. Historically, in other jurisdictions, it's quite true that the high-end luxury premium retail is cyclical in nature. And for something like India, people usually expected that the value retail segment would be more robust and more resilient to a downturn. But from whatever data we see, it looks like that the value retail is under pressure, and that's not very surprising when one looks at the fact that the private consumption expenditure is at a 34 quarter low, and how bad it is sort of exemplified by the fact that if I take a look at private consumption expenditure for last 6 quarters, you'd have 4 quarters within that which have the lowest growth readings for this specific private consumption expenditure in the last 34 quarters. So we are possibly entering a phase of low consumption right now. We expect this to continue for another 2 to 4 quarters at least, because the drivers which will sort of bring back this private consumption expenditure is essentially low consumer inflation, which is not getting controlled, and high real wage growth, which is a lot driven by corporate profits and government spending.